Welcome to Vatican. Hey everyone, welcome to yet another travel video from Europe. This one is from the Vatican City. There is so much I want to tell you about Vatican City. Though Vatican is tiny, it has massive historical importance. It is the smallest country in the world with a total population of only 800. It is a walled country which is headed by the Pope, called Pope Francis at the moment. And it has over 20 museums, including the Sistine Chapel and also the St. Peter's Basilica. So guys, now from Rome, we are moving to the Vatican City. And the amazing fact is that we came by bus and metro. So you can imagine, you can visit from one country to the other in the public conveyance, as simple as a metro. So over to Amit.
So we have come to Ottavio station, metro station, and we are walking to the Vatican Gardens, and then we'll be over to the Vatican Museum, and then we plan to do Sistine Chapel, and after that we will do St. Peter's Church.
One tip for all the first timers at Vatican: stay away from the skip the line tickets. It's of no use. I am in the regular queue, whereas skip the line queue is longer and cost about 30 euros, which we saved. We just bought the regular ticket for the Vatican Museum and entered and saw everything for just 17 euros.
So the Vatican Museum is like 14 kilometers, so you have to follow this map. It's available downstairs at the ticket counter. So the ticket price is 17 euros per person, and for this map there are like 19 points that you can see, including all the famous paintings, sculptures, the architectures, everything. All the things were collected by the Pope over the years, over the centuries.
If you see this list on the screen, this about the museums we have, seconds of them have at least 2 to 3 different parts or rooms, and I am going to take you through most of them which were open on the day of my visit. So as you can see the screen right now, the walls carry a series of niche displaying colossal statues imitating the Pantheon architecture. The Hall of Animals, the animals are the main protagonists, can be seen both in action curiously with one another. Make the most out of your Vatican visit. I advise to plan a little early, like start at 9 when it opens and complete it by 6. And I'm sure time also not enough everything which Vatican has to offer. There is so much to see, right from the Vatican museums, which range from about 25 of them, along with the St. Peter's Basilica and Sistine Chapel. Now look at these galleries and just adore the work the artists, the painters have done on it. And it is worth applause, it is worth all admiration you can give. Each of these galleries and rooms have a story of their own. To know the detailed portions, you can check out the Vatican Museum's official website. I'm going to link down in the description box for you to see. And everything is so neatly and thoroughly mentioned over there that you cannot have any doubt left. And before heading to the next section, I found these beautiful gems. Now we are in the Egyptian portions, and I'm sure we all have read this in our history books, and it was such an honor to see this right in front of my eyes. And I could also see some restoration work going on.
I am not able to walk anymore. That's
Though I was dead tired, but looking at these beautiful paintings, I was totally thrilled and excited and kept on walking till I reached the exit point of the Vatican Museum. And here you could find a complete treasure island which you could carry back home. Museums. Moving on to the best part, the St. Peter's Square, and followed by the St. Peter's Basilica. Guys, this place is outstanding. It was like welcoming me with two arms wide open. If you can see picturizingly, it meant just like to reach on a Wednesday 9 o'clock in the morning. You also meet the Pope.
Hi guys, I'm inside St. Peter's Basilica. As you can see, this church is huge and only here you can meet the great Pope. The
interior of St. Peter's is filled with many masterpieces of Renaissance and Baroque art, among the most famous of which are Michelangelo's Pieta, the Bulb by Bernini, the statue of St. Longinus Crossing, the tomb of Urban VIII, and the bronze cathedral of St. Peter in the Apse. Not the Sistine Chapel. The most important artworks in the chapel are the frescoes by Michelangelo on the ceiling, West Wall, Bengio. Finish this video and thank you so much for watching, guys. For my other videos, bye!